الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
السلام عليكم. Ramadan Mubarak. May Allah bless you all on this Ramadan. I would like to say a few words about Ramadan and let you know that Allah has given us Ramadan so that we may learn taqwa. Taqwa is the important aspect of Islam that everyone needs to learn. Taqwa is that which you need to survive on the slope of Mustaqim. It is that which allows you to avoid that which is wrong for you, that which is harmful to you. It allows you to enjoin what is right and to forbid what is wrong. It is that strength and that understanding and that knowledge that one acts upon as an imperative to knowledge. It is the understanding that success and that righteousness and that the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His rewards are for those who persevere in these activities of taqwa. Taqwa is this knowledge that one holds in the heart and that one displays in the action. It is a matter of the heart, it is a matter of the tongue, and it is a matter of the limbs. Taqwa is that which we act upon because of our certainty, our yaqeen, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of all things, He's the originator of all things, He's the decider of all things, He's the judge of all things, He's the fashion of all things. And we say that Allah, He's the one that has all control over the power, He is the power. He's Al-Qadr, and He is the one who has decreed and gave everything its balance, its weight, its capacity. He's prescribed for us a particular end, either a good or bad end, in the hell or in the Jannah. He's the one who has decreed these things in these matters. So it's Him that we trust, not the men of the earth or anyone else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to trust in Him, trust in His word, trust in this Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us Ramadan as a time, a month of blessings. It is a month where every good deed that we do is increased abundantly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this month so that we can reflect on Him. It is the month in which the Quran was revealed. It is the month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received His message. It is the month in which all good things that are available to you can be magnified by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing. And the parable of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessing is like that grain of corn that you plant. You plant one grain of corn, and it bears one stalk, and on that stalk there are 7 ears of corn. And on each ear of corn there may be 700 seeds or more. So this is like the month of Ramadan, and it is even greater than that. Our blessings are multiplied, our acts and righteous deeds are multiplied, and our sins are forgiven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this month, and if you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must remain conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and avoid what is wrong and forbid it in your actions. Enjoin what is right and forbid what is wrong. This is the task that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts before us. And may all you enjoy this morning, eat your suhoor, and alhamdulillah, be ready for the first day of Ramadan. It's a beautiful thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us nearly 30 years of Ramadan in this family, the Bani Alameen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Bani Alameen and the friends of the Bani Alameen and all the righteous believers. Allah send blessings on all the righteous imams and all the followers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Ummah of Rasulullah Salam. Allah bless my family, bless my loved ones, bless my friends, keep them safe, and keep them far from the fire. Ameen. Salamu alaikum.